Video shows apparent beheading of British hay worker David Haynes by ISIS. Appears hours after family's plea for safe return. David Haynes read a prepared statement on the video saying British Prime Minister David Cameron is entirely responsible for my execution, which appeared to be at the hands of Jihadi John. Cameron and President Obama released similar statements, which said the murderers will be brought to justice. The Islamic State savages have struck again. The brutal band of Sunni jihadists released a video Saturday showing the beheading of a British hay worker, a cold-blooded execution his nation's Prime Minister David Cameron labeled an act of pure evil. The gruesome 2-minute, 27-second clip shows David Haynes, 44, kneeling on a sandy hill while a black-clad executioner stands behind him clutching a knife. Before he's slain, Haynes reads from a script, blaming Cameron for his murder. The setting and script are similar to those used in the beheadings of American journalist James Foley and Stephen Sloss. "My name is David Cawthorn Haynes," he says. "I would like to declare that I hold you, David Cameron, entirely responsible for my execution. You entered voluntarily into a coalition with the United States against the Islamic State, just as your predecessor Tony Blair did, following a trend amongst our British prime ministers who can't find the courage to say no to the Americans. Unfortunately, it is we, the British public, that in the end will pay for the price for our parliament's selfish decisions." Then the executioner, who appears to be the same monster responsible for killing Foley and Sloss, speaks directly into the camera in a now familiar British accent. "This British man has to pay the price for your promise, Cameron, to arm the Peshmerga against the Islamic State," hisses the terrorist known as Jihadi John. Ironically, he has spent a decade of his life serving under the brutal air force that is responsible for delivering those arms. "Your evil alliance with America, which continues to strike the Muslims of Iraq and most recently bombed the Hatatha Dam, will only accelerate your destruction, and playing a role of the obedient lapdog, Cameron, will only drag you and your people into another bloody and unwinnable war." The video, titled "A Message to the Allies of America," ends ominously. The executioner is shown standing over and grabbing the collar of another captured Brit, gallant heading. "If you, Cameron, insist on fighting the Islamic State, then you, like your master, Obama, will have the blood of your people on your hands," the deranged terrorist says. Haynes' brother said his brave sibling, the married father of two who dedicated much of his life to him. Was murdered in cold blood. After a stint with the British Royal Air Force, Haynes provided aid to conflict victims in the Balkans, Africa, and the Middle East. "David was most alive and enthusiastic in his humanitarian roles," Mike Haynes said in a statement. "His joy and anticipation for the work he went to do in Syria is for myself and family the most important element of this whole sad affair. He was and is loved by all his family and will be missed terribly." In a statement, Cameron said the execution of Haynes was despicable and appalling. He added, "My heart goes out to the family of David Haynes, who have shown extraordinary courage and fortitude throughout this ordeal. We will do everything in our power to hunt down these murderers and ensure they face justice, however long it takes." The Prime Minister stated, "We have to confront the menace and would work to dismantle and destroy ISIS in a calm, deliberate way, but with an iron determination. We are a peaceful people. We do not seek out confrontation. But we need to understand. We cannot ignore this threat to our security and that of our allies," he said. The nation's foreign office released a statement Sunday that all signs are the video is genuine. Downing Street announced early Sunday that Cameron will preside over an emergency meeting of his top security officials to discuss Britain's next step. President Obama condemned Haines' barbaric murder. Our hearts go out to the family of Mr. Haines and to the people of the United Kingdom, Obama said in a Saturday night statement. We will work with the United Kingdom and a broad coalition of nations from the region and around the world to bring the perpetrators of this outrageous act to justice, and to degrade and destroy this threat to the people of our countries, the region and the world. In addition to Haines, the ISIS extremists are believed to be holding captive another British citizen, as well as two other American aid workers. The families of the kidnapped asked the news media not to reveal the captives' names because ISIS warned they would be killed if relatives made their identities public, the New York Times reported. The video showing Haines' murder was posted to Twitter hours after his family made a public plea for mercy early Saturday. We are the family of David Haines, their statement began. We are asking those holding David to make contact with us. Haines was taken hostage in Syria in March 2013, while working with a group to assist tens of thousands of refugees displaced by the country's three-year civil war. He was traveling to the Turkish border when gunmen shot out the tires of the car he was riding in, surrounded the vehicle and took him and an Italian colleague hostage. His wife has spoken out about his capture. He's our life. He's a fantastic man and father, Dragana Haines told The Telegraph. Nobody can understand how we are feeling. My daughter keeps asking about him every day. ISIS beheaded Foley in August, going to murder laws, 31, if the United States strikes in Iraq continued. A video showing Salah's beheading was released on September 2, despite televised pleas from his mother asking for mercy for her son. At the end of the Salah's video, an image of Haines was shown with a terrorist, who vowed he would be next. With Newswire Services. Three United States and UK nationals have been beheaded by ISIS in shocking videos demanding President Obama and his allies back off their bombing runs in Syria. The murdered men are James Foley, 40. The American journalist from New Hampshire was covering the Syrian civil war when he was captured in November 2012. At the time, he was working for the U.S.-based online outlet Global Post. The video of his beheading was released August 19. Stephen Salaz, 31. The South Florida native and freelance journalist wrote for Time and the Christian Science Monitor. He traveled to the Middle East to cover the suffering of Muslims at the hands of tyrants, according to his mother, Shirley Salaz, who put out a video pleading with ISIS to spare her son. Salaz disappeared in August 2013. ISIS released a video of his beheading on September 2. David Haines, 44. The British aid worker, employed by a Paris-based humanitarian aid agency, was captured in March 2013 near a Syrian refugee camp. The video of his beheading was released Saturday, the same day his family tried to reach out to his captors through the British Foreign Office. Alan Henning, age unknown. The man who could be next on the ISIS kill list is a British citizen and humanitarian aid worker believed to be from the Manchester area. The British government on Saturday was trying to confirm video suggesting he will be ISIS' next innocent victim. Those who know Henning claimed he was taken by ISIS in Al Dana, in northern Syria.